And now we are going to enter our first few transactions. You will see that when we record transactions, the accounts that we previously put in the chart of accounts will start showing up in the trial balance for the money amounts of the transaction. For example, our first transaction will be January 1, HATTY deposited the total daily cash sales into the bank account. So let's imagine the total cash in the cash register was $10,000, and when she brought it to the bank, they gave her deposit slip number 1. Well, what will happen when we record this transaction in the register? Well, if we earned $10,000 in income from customers, it means that daily cash sales will show up on the trial balance for the first time as $10,000. And if the money was deposited in the bank, it means the cash and bank account from the chart of accounts will also show up on the trial balance. When we take a look at the transaction only at the trial balance, we'll see the money amounts. Daily cash sales will show up as $10,000. Cash and bank will show up as $10,000. So let's see how to record this. If your register window is open from the previous video, that's fine. If not, click Banking, Use Register, and OK. If your trial balance is open from the previous video, that's fine too. If not, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Trial Balance. Don't forget to push the A button on your keyboard to change the pull-down menu choice to All. Okay, readjust the trial balance. Your screen is a little bit bigger than mine, so I'm going to keep mine together and just click anywhere in the window to bring that window forward. Now let's record the transaction. Click once on, now, once again, the way the register looks now, there are 2 lines for every 1 transaction. So we will record the first transaction on these 2 lines. The first thing you always put is the date. Click once on the calendar box to bring the date box. I happen to be recording this in April of 2015, so I would have to go all the way back to the month of January by clicking the back button and click the day of the month. The number that goes in this field, when you click to put the number in this field, remove what QuickBooks puts and put the number on whatever the source document is. In this case, it's deposit slip number 0001. Now, there is no payee in this transaction, so this pull-down menu we will leave blank because we're not paying a vendor. However, there is an account that we have to associate with this transaction. The reason why we're making this deposit is because we earned income from the daily cash sales in the register. So the account we choose from the pull-down list represents the reason why. Click Daily Cash Sales. Because this is a deposit, we must put the money in the deposit column, not the payment column. You must make sure that you put it here. Click deposit, type in the money amount. Now, to save any information in a field, a little box inside a whole window, move your finger to the top left of your keyboard and push the tab key. When you push the tab key, it will save the little field without closing the window. And when you push the tab key, the cursor moves over. We now recorded all the information we need about this transaction. When we click record, we get a warning message from QuickBooks. You will get this warning message until we are able to shut this off. So for now, just ignore this message and just click yes. Now when we bring our trial balance forward, we notice the results in the trial balance are the same as they were in the animation a moment ago. We notice that the numbers are exactly what we expected. Now let's take a look at our second transaction. Let's imagine on January 2, HATTY wrote check number 1 to Rex Repair for fixing something in the store, and she paid him $500. Well, if we pay a repair for the first time, that means repair expense, the one that we put in the chart of accounts, is going to show up on the trial balance for the first time as $500. So what will the trial balance look like after we record the second transaction? Well, cash in bank is going to change into $9,500 because we just paid $500. And repair expense will show up on the trial balance for the first time as $500. Let's take a look. Now let's record this in the register. Click on the calendar box and put the date January 2. Click in the number field, and this time we happen to agree with the suggested number that QuickBooks gives us, because this is check number 1. The payee, we can click this arrow, and we can put whom we're paying the money to. In this case, we're paying Rex Repair. Notice all of the vendors that you put on the vendor list show up here. Now, the reason why we're paying Rex Repair is what we'll put directly under it when we click the account pull-down menu choice. Notice when we click the account arrow, all of the accounts from our chart of accounts show up here. We choose repair expense because that's the reason for this check. If it is a payment, you have to be careful not to put it in the right column. You have to put it in the left column. Type in the number, do not put a comma, do not put a decimal point. Just type in the number and push the tab key. Now we have everything for this transaction. The date, the vendor, the account, the check. Make sure it says check number 1. Be careful. Sometimes it's tricky. You have to go back there. And $500. Now when we click record, again, don't worry about any other kind of pop-ups. Just read them and click past them so that we can bring forward our trial balance. And notice, repair expense shows up for the first time as $500, and cash in bank went down by $500 because we just paid $500 from cash in bank. Our last transaction in this video will be January 3. HATTY wrote check number 2 to Con Edison for electricity, $500. Well, that means cash in bank is going to decrease and become $9,000, and it means electric expense will show up for the first time on the trial balance as $500. So let's take a look. We'll put the date as January 3rd. Make sure it says check number 2. The people whom we pay are Con Edison, and the reason we're paying is electric expense. Make sure you put the $500 in the payment column. Don't forget to push the tab key to make sure you save the field after you type in information. When we click record, once again, whatever messages you get, click whatever you need to go past these messages so that you can bring forward your trial balance, and notice the results are exactly as what we would expect.